Hello everyone, I heartily welcome you to my page and I will tell you the story about a person who was very much devoted to God. His name is Daniel and all his adventures with God can be found in the book of Daniel from the Bible. Today's story is about Daniel, King Darius and the lions. Now, Daniel was a Jew who worked in the king's palace as a high official. King Darius favored him far more than any other governor because he was very efficient. So he decided to put Daniel in charge of the whole country. However, the other officials grew jealous of his advancement. Now, interestingly, this scenario can be compared to today's workplace situation, isn't it? Where an outstanding person's colleagues are envious of him. So, the jealous ministers of Daniel decided to trap him by finding faults with his work. However, they found that it was impossible because Daniel worked very efficiently. So they had to find another way to trap him, and it was through his religion. You see, Daniel prayed 3 times a day by the open window. Now, surprisingly, unlike most of us, he didn't withdraw from his public life to live in a forest or cave to serve his God in isolation. Also, he didn't pray behind closed doors in his room without being seen by anyone and living his life in luxury, power and influence and being indistinguishable from all around him. Instead, he chose a better way by being publicly devoted to God. He used to go to the upper room where the window was open, and he prayed 3 times a day, and it was known to everyone, including the king, that he was devoted to God very much. To make their idea a success, these officials, they went to the king and requested him to make a law that for 30 days, nobody was allowed to ask anything from anybody, including God. And if anyone doesn't obey the law, he will be punished by death. Now, this is also similar to today's times where the government issues an order and whoever doesn't follow the law is being punished. Now, after this rule was enforced, Daniel was found guilty of breaking the law, because he prayed to his God, which was not allowed. Daniel's colleagues immediately went to the king to report the matter. The king was not at all expecting this because he loved Daniel a lot and trusted him. And he couldn't bear the pain of losing Daniel by death. So the king tried to rescue him in many ways, but in vain. Finally, the king, with a heavy heart, ordered to arrest Daniel, and he told Daniel that let the God whom you serve so faithfully, let him protect you. After that, Daniel was arrested and thrown into a pit of hungry lions, and the mouth of the pit was sealed. The king couldn't sleep the whole night. In the morning, he anxiously went to the pit and called out to Daniel. Daniel answered the king and told him that he was safe because God protected him by sending for him an angel to shut the mouth of lions. The king was overjoyed and immediately ordered Daniel to be pulled out from the pit, and instead the king put Daniel's enemies into the pit of bees. Then the king Darius wrote a letter to the people of all nations, races, and languages on earth. Greetings! I command that throughout the empire, everyone should fear and respect Daniel's God. He is a living God and he will rule forever. His kingdom will never be destroyed and his power will never come to an end. He saves and rescues. He performs wonders and miracles in heaven and on earth. He saved Daniel from being killed by lions. Daniel prospered under the reign of King Darius and also the reign of Cyrus the Persian. So, to sum up, you should not leave God under any circumstances